All right, and welcome back. This is module 3 where we're going to be talking about beliefs. And now one of the biggest beliefs that I actually want to just like rip apart for you if I can is the belief that there's actually good and bad and right and wrong in this world, right? Like this is something that completely trips most of us up in so many more ways than we would care to realize. And so for a long time, I was one of those people who believed that there was a right and wrong way to do things and good and bad people and all of that stuff, right? Now, I really choose to operate from a place of thinking that there's only that that's supportive and that that's unsupportive for the type of life that I want to live for myself, right? And so this has actually created a ton of freedom for me because I no longer feel the need to prove my point or to argue or to defend myself against anything or anyone, right? I simply understand that there's going to be things that are useful for me that may or may not be useful for someone else. And there's going to be things that are useful for other people that may or may not be useful for me. And the truth of the matter is that I don't know what someone else's goals, what type of life that they want to have, what their financial situation, what their time constraints are, you know, what their family situation is. So I really have no right to assume, we all know what happens when you assume, that what they're doing in their lives is somehow wrong, or that by them doing something, it's making me wrong in what I'm choosing to do, right? And so what it really does when you abandon the belief that there's a right and wrong and a good and a bad, is that it creates a ton of space for you to be able to sit back and just say, huh, so if there's nothing that's right or wrong, or good or bad, and there's only things that are useful and unuseful for me, what in my life do I have around me constantly that is actually unsupportive of me and the type of life that I want to create for myself, right? And this is a real question. It's a deep question. Like, what do you have around you on a consistent basis that is unsupportive? They might be bad habits like smoking or not working out or people that gossip, or you know, maybe you're a complainer, maybe you find something negative about every single situation, right? Like, is that really supportive for you, right? Like, if I come to you with a solution and you point out all of the reasons why it won't work, are you problem focused or are you solution focused, right? I choose to be solution focused. So we can sit here and say like, look, there's a problem right here. Do you see how big this problem is? Oh my gosh, it's so big. And for me, I'm like, well, there's a problem. Okay, like, what's the solution, right? Like, what am I redirecting my attention to, my focus to? Because whatever you put your attention on, it's just going to expand. That's the law of the universe, right? What you focus on expands. And so, you know, by bringing a little bit of focus to this and saying like, okay, I know that there are things in my life that are unsupportive. I know that I have habits that are unsupportive. I know that I have people that are unsupportive. I know that I have relationships that are unsupportive. I know that I have, things that I spend my money on or that I put into my body or whatever the case may be that are unsupportive for the type of life that you really want to have or the type of person that you really want to be. You can actually extract those things from your life and say, huh, this has been unsupportive and I've been doing it unconsciously this whole time. Let me go back through and make a conscious decision and start creating systematically and very deliberately the type of life that I want to live. So that's my assignment for you this week. And I really, really am so excited for you guys to start identifying these unsupportive behaviors and patterns and people and things and experiences that you have in your life and starting to systematically turn them around so that they can actually bring you closer to the type of life and the type of person that you ultimately want to be. Because this is all about self-discovery, right? It's through these questions, through these exercises that you're discovering who it is that you are, what it is that you want, and where it is that you're ultimately going. So this is Yada Golden reminding you to live your life on purpose today, and I'll see you in the next module.